Colonel Ruffs has dropped in Brawl Stars, and his super might be the most interesting thing about him because you can buff your teammates and we don't really have a brawler that can do that. But I think it's also important to consider that his main attack is pretty solid. And I've already made a video talking about the best ways to use his super and tips and tricks related to that, so of course you can always watch that after this video, but I want to focus on his main attack and all the stats associated with it and use that to give some tips and tricks on how you can auto aim, how you can bounce shots better, everything you're gonna need to know. So Colonel Ruff's main attack has a total width of about 0.93 tiles, so just under tile width that the two projectiles shoot out in. And then they'll go up to a range of 9 tiles, and you'll get an extra tile of range for every time the projectiles bounce off a wall, up to 3 times. So you can have a max of 12 tiles of range if the projectiles bounce off walls 3 times. And now I think it's really helpful to compare this main attack to Rico, because it's pretty similar. If you just take one of these single bouncy balls from Rico's attack, then it behaves pretty similar to Ruff's main attack. So now Rico's main attack has a width of 0.67 tiles, so it's actually a bit thinner than Ruff's attack, but if you take one of the projectiles individually from Ruff's attack, then Rico's attack is obviously going to be bigger. And Rico actually has a slightly larger range at 9.67 tiles, so he has an extra 2/3 of tiles of range, and every time a ball bounces off a wall, it actually gains 1.67 tiles of range, so once again, another 0.67 tiles of range for every tile you're bouncing. And in terms of how the projectiles actually bounce off the wall, there's nothing strange there, it's sort of a basic physics principle that the angle at which they hit the wall is going to be the angle at which they bounce off the wall. And most of the time, Ruff's main projectiles are going to be so close together that they bounce in the exact same ways, and so they'll essentially function as a single unit just like they would in a shot from Rico. And since Ruff's shot is a lot wider than Rico's, you can expect that you're probably going to hit your shots more often with Colonel Ruff's, but sometimes you're only going to be able to hit with one of your projectiles, so you might be doing less damage even though you're going to hit more often in the long run. And of course the shorter range is also a slight weakness that Colonel Ruff's is going to have compared to a single bullet from Rico's attack. And so the main thing that's going to separate Ruff's from Rico is when you aim your shot so that the two different projectiles go in different directions, because that's obviously something Rico can't do since every single individual bouncy ball is a single unit that you can't split up. So the way to get projectiles to go into different directions is to do something near the corner of a wall. So if you aim directly at the corner of the wall from far away, you can get them to bounce in opposite directions. Usually, it's not going to be that useful to do this because you'd have to have two opponents perfectly positioned in order to hit both your shots. And even then, does it really matter if you were hitting two opponents at once with half the damage as opposed to just hitting one opponent with full damage? It doesn't really make much of a difference. So where the split attack is really going to get a bit of an advantage for Colonel Ruffs is when you're standing right behind the corner of the wall and you aim at it. This is going to let one of the projectiles go past the corner of the wall while the other one is just going to bounce straight back and do whatever it wants. But the reason this is good is because that one projectile, let's just assume it's the right projectile that goes past the corner, that's going to be pretty far to the right of where you're standing. So that means you can get almost full protection from the wall and still be able to hit around it. And no other brawler in the game can really do this well, except for someone like Gale, who has a similar attack with multiple projectiles. And the reason this is the case is because the way attacks go around walls is if at least half of the projectile is not in contact with the wall, then it will go straight past the wall. So that's why with someone like Nita's attack, you can aim at the wall, and even though it looks like part of your attack is hitting the wall, the entire attack goes through the wall. And that's just because more than half of the width of the attack is not aiming at the wall. So basically, if the very center of your aiming line is not going towards the wall, then your attack won't hit the wall. And usually that center of your aiming line is perfectly aligned with the center of you, where you're standing. But with Ruff's, the center line of his right projectile is going to be aligned slightly to the right of where he's standing. So that lets him stand behind a wall while still getting one of his shots to go around it. And so that puts you in positions like these, where you can hit someone around the wall, but they can't hit you. And now obviously you could just bounce your shots off the walls here, but assuming there weren't walls and you were in a position where there's just this only wall that's blocking your shot and someone standing behind it, then you would be able to hit them and they wouldn't be able to hit you, and that's a pretty solid advantage to have. Even though it's only half damage, you're still outputting a decent amount of threat and you're at least preventing them from healing, which is pretty good. So now another important thing to consider with Colonel Ruff's main attack is when you can auto aim, because Colonel Ruff's unload speed is extremely quickly, fastest in the game. You can basically unload all your shots instantly. It's only really limited by how fast you can tap. And so if you're able to auto aim with your shots, then that's just an insane amount of damage that you're going to be getting in a really short period of time. So in order to calculate whether or not you can auto-aim, you basically just have to determine whether or not your opponents can move out of the way from where your auto-aim would be targeted by the time the projectiles make it to them. So we have to know the projectile speed, which turns out to be 11.67 tiles per second. And since someone's going to have to move about 0.5 tiles away from where you're aiming in order to dodge the shots by the time the projectiles make it to them, then assuming they have, at the higher end, it would be something like a 2.7 tile per second movement speed. That's if you are fast to very fast. Then it would take 0.185 seconds for your opponent to move that 0.5 tiles and get out of the way from being hit by both projectiles. And then using the projectile speed, we can see that we need to be 2.2 tiles or closer to them in order to get your projectiles to them before they're able to fully dodge it. So that means you're going to hit both projectiles if you are 2.2 tiles or closer to them. And you can actually be a lot farther away to just hit one projectile. That's actually closer to your max range. But if you're manually aiming, you're probably hitting one projectile most of the time anyway. So that's not as big of a deal. But like I said, that was for fast and very fast movement speed brawlers. On the lower ends, if we have the slower brawlers, they are at about 2.4 tiles per second movement speed. So that means it's going to take them 0.208 seconds to move those 0.5 tiles to dodge one of your projectiles. And so then once again, using the projectile speed, we can calculate that you need to be 2.4 tiles or closer in order to get your projectiles to them before they're able to dodge. So that means in general, if you're not really sure what the movement speed of your opponents are, then you want to be in a range that's like 2.2 to 2.4 tiles away from them in order to be able to auto-aim your shots and get max damage. Obviously, closer is better and you'll be more guaranteed that your shots will actually hit them. But 2.4 tiles is the absolute limit. Past that point, you want to manually aim with your shots. And if you do manage to hit all three shots auto-aimed, that's 4,200 damage just like that. And if you're charged up from your super, you're actually doing 5,040 damage in the span of like a second. So that's very, very good 1v1 capability to have. And even though Ruffs doesn't seem like a brawler that would be the best in 1v1s or in close range interactions, the fact that he can auto aim within two tiles and unload his attacks just so ridiculously fast actually makes him pretty good against brawlers that he can wipe out with three shots. So brawlers with less than 5,040 health. And that's pretty much all you need to know about Ruff's main attack. There are some fancy things you can do, like trying to get one shot to go past a wall and having the other shot bounce in a different direction. But realistically, there's no situation where you're going to intentionally do that and get a lot of value out of it. At the best, you're going to be able to hit two different opponents for half damage, but like I said, it's usually just better to hit a single opponent for full damage because it takes a lot less skill to do that, and there's not really much difference in terms of HP advantage you get over the opponent's team. So most of the time you're going to be playing similar to Rico in that you can bounce your shots when necessary, but a lot of times you can just aim straight at your opponent. But I do think the hiding behind walls and shooting just one projectile out is a pretty good strategy that you can adopt with Ruffs that you can't adopt with Rico. So do keep that in mind. If you like this video, make sure to leave a like and a comment down below, and please subscribe if you want to see more videos like this and be notified whenever they come out. But that's all for today, guys. So see you later.